What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel, man. Lupin Norris here. I got another episode of album reaction where I go over the most recent rap albums of 2023 and 2024, mostly 2024. Today we're gonna do the new album The Force by LL Cool J. He recently dropped this one earlier this month. I think it's the perfect album to do for this segment, man. LL Cool J, this guy's like a super legend, very strong lyricist for a long time, super famous. He had his whole career, became an actor, and now coming back 2024, dropping an album with Q-Tip, the Abstract, Q-Tip from A Tribe Called Quest. He produced the album, most of the album, I believe. He produced almost every track on this one. So the new album, The Force, I'm gonna go over this one. Before I do, the new song, Abracadabra, that's out on all platforms. The next song, Learn How to Swim. This one's set for September 24th. It's the last single I'll be dropping for this year, up until I say maybe around December. Then I'll continue to drop singles up until the next project. Obviously, this is gonna be the last project I'll be releasing for this year. Like I said earlier, this is the final boss out of the three that I dropped this year. So once I drop it, you gotta listen to it, man, on all platforms. This one will be available everywhere, not just my Bandcamp account, but everywhere else where I post my music, you'll be able to find this one. So October 4th, make sure you check that out. Just like every other episode, I'm gonna play out a few of the songs off the album, just a snippet of it, give you guys an idea of how it sounds like. After I play those songs, I'm gonna start talking about the album, giving you guys my full review on the album, how it sounds like. I'll try to go as detailed as possible, give you guys a rating at the end of the video. We're gonna get right into this one. All right, man, so this is off of SoundCloud. The first song I'll play, this one's Murder Gram Duh featuring Eminem. This one's called Postmodern. This one's called Passion. The last track I'll play, this one's called Spirit of Cyrus featuring Snoop Dogg. It's only right I kill it. Black blood, you're quick to spill it. Justified, rape and pillage. Hide behind your image and terrorize my village. Your life, you won't live it. LL Cool J. This guy's been a legendary rapper for a very long time. Before he even got into his acting career, this guy had a crazy rap career, closer to like the early 90s, around the time when Run-DMC and the Beastie Boys were the biggest rap groups in the game. And they were achieving worldwide success, going on world tours. LL Cool J was right there with them. He's a old school, very old school rapper. So it's really cool to see him drop an album in 2024. He's in his 50s currently, so it's really cool to see. He still has a strong pen and he can still like rap. From Long Island, New York, New York rapper that turned into an actor later on in his career. You can look at him as like Drake back in the day, where he was like super lyrical, but he was achieving mainstream success as if he was like a pop star artist, but he was a rapper getting pop numbers. That's why I compare him to Drake. LL Cool J, man, one of those rappers that relies heavily on his pen, on his lyrical ability, being able to rap in every kind of way, basically being able to come up with lines that make you think, but it doesn't force you to play the song like a million times before you finally understand what type of line he's trying to make, or what type of metaphor, simile he's trying to make. He's the kind of rapper that can make up lines where they're hard hitting, they make you think, and you'll automatically understand what he's saying right when you listen to it from the first time. So that's not an easy thing to do when you're writing rap verses. He raps on every beat as if it's the last beat he'll ever rap on. I respect that heavily. LL Cool J is one of those rappers that I grew up listening to and sort of learning off of to improve my own music. It's really cool to see a lot of old school rappers dropping albums this year. I really hope it continues on throughout this year up until next year, and You got like every old school rapper that you can think of drop like a new album after listening to this one, man. What I expected, because LL Cool J, this guy is like a lyrical legend in the game. So I'm not too surprised about how good the album sounds, especially seeing that Q-Tip the Abstract is the main producer for the album, and Q-Tip's one of my favorite producers to ever exist. Also one of my favorite rappers. It's really cool to see him take a step back and only focus on the production on the album. He's like in and out of tracks, backup vocals, maybe not the hook of the song, but you'll hear Q-Tip say like a few things on the track, sort of like in a skit way, and then hop off the track. LL Cool J jumps in. It's mostly the beats that Q-Tip's responsible for. So that's really cool to see, honestly, because Q-Tip's one of the greatest producers ever. Great feature list. Got guys like Snoop Dogg, Eminem, Fat Joe, Rick Ross, a lot of older rappers that LL Cool J has featured on the album, which is perfect. It's what you expect out of an older rapper to have like older features on it. It's more suitable with the type of beats that LL Cool J is given on this one. And the production, man, I think Q-Tip went to another level when it comes to the beats on here. It competes with Big Sean's album in terms of the best produced album. A perfect balance between experimental and accessible sound. Most experimental style songs and beats are pretty hard to listen to. JPEG Mafia, perfect example. When you listen to a lot of his beats, they're kind of hard to listen to because of how he like puts them together with his like drum patterns and his sampling style. It reminds me a little bit of JPEG Mafia in terms of making the beat as experimental as possible. Q-Tip was in his bag trying to make beats that no one's ever heard before, and he did an excellent job on making the beats as experimental as possible, as unique as possible, but also making them accessible so that everybody can enjoy them and it's easier to listen to, it's easier to like dance to. And like, beats that can make you dance, that makes you want to dance, are usually the best type of beats in my opinion. Even his back in the day with his like A Tribe Called Quest days, like these beats sound nothing like what Q-Tip's made before in his past. So that's actually a really cool thing about the album. Just like the production on this album, how he was able to balance out experimentation and also accessibility, LL Cool J did the same thing with his songwriting and his lyrics on this one. Like I said, I'm not surprised, because before listening to this album, I already knew how good of a lyricist LL Cool J was. Like, I'm not surprised at all, but this guy displays incredible rapping skills all throughout the album. Like I was saying earlier, LL Cool J is one of those rappers that goes off on every single beat. He gives 100% effort on every track, and he displays that heavily on this album. Every verse that he puts down on this album sounds like he's given his absolute all. Like, it's the last beat, last album he'll ever work on. That's how hard he's going on every track, you know what I mean? Like, he doesn't take days off. With his like lyrics, he does a good job at balancing out accessibility and experimentation, just like Q-Tip with the production. It meshes perfectly with the style of beats Q-Tip offers him. He's giving you punchlines that are easy to understand, but they're also lines that you're not used to hearing from rappers. Like, he's offering gems through his lines. At the same time, they go perfectly with the beat. Well put together similes and metaphors. Just very smartly written lines. They're so understandable and accessible that you don't really need to play the song like a million times to understand it. Like, he's always been good at that. I'm still a little bit surprised by how futuristic the album sounds. I was expecting it to sound a little more on the old school side, because I mean, LL Cool J, he is still an old school rapper that was big in the early 90s, which was a really long time ago. I think he's 56 right now. He's in his 50s rapping. So I'm thinking that this album is gonna sound super old school. The producer is Q-Tip, the Abstract, right? Another very old artist. I'm expecting this thing to sound mad old school. Like, it's an album that belongs in the 90s, but they used a lot of new school techniques on this one, which is another really cool thing about it. It sounds like Q-Tip's using an MPC, most throughout the album. Very sampled bass beats. He uses a lot of techniques, maybe some live instruments. The way he mixes the beats sounds very futuristic. Sounds like something that definitely belongs in today's day and age when it comes to the sound of rap. Very futuristic sounding album, even with LL Cool J's raps. He sounds like he's rapping the way he did in the 90s, but a lot of the referencing and a lot of the metaphors that he's using in his verses sound very futuristic and up to date. He sounds like a rapper that belongs in the 2020s, and as well as the features that he has on the album. It's a lot of old school rappers that are using up to date flows for the songs to make the sound of the album a lot more futuristic, what most people will expect. There isn't a lot of bad things that I gotta say about the album. This album is really good, man. Yeah, man, LL Cool J, man, he did his thing on this one. The beats stand out the most. Q-Tip did a crazy job with the beats. They sound like they can be used for a New School, A Tribe Called Quest album. Rest in peace, Fife Dawg. If Fife Dawg was still alive, it would be so dope if Q-Tip linked up with Shaheed Muhammad. They put together another A Tribe Called Quest album. I think a lot of the beats would sound the same as the beats that you hear on this album, just different like ways of sampling the songs that he does. Even the song selection, when he's sampling, he's taking songs that like I've never even heard before. I'm just like, what are these sounds, man? The gold that he finds, he really is the type of producer that like really digs deep in the crates to find something that no one's ever heard before. Always looking for the rarest records to sample. Q-Tip's always been that type of producer. He reminds me of Andre 3000. They're almost like the same type of artists, the way their brain works, being a super high level rapper, super high level producer, and having a very eccentric style of thinking. They always trying to make music completely different from any other artist you've heard from before through their production and through their raps. So that has been displayed heavily throughout this album. There isn't a lot of flaws on this album. These guys really did their thing on this one, man. This is honestly the greatest year for hip hop, because like we're getting some crazy albums this year, man. The only bad thing I can probably say, and like I'm trying to think like hard what I can say bad about the album. Obviously, I'm not saying every song sounds the same, because like it's like the opposite of that. Every song is completely different, and even the way LL Cool J approaches every beat is a little bit different too. He comes with like a different flow every time. Just the overall sound of every track is completely different from the next. But like, for the same reason, I feel like the album gets a little boring at points, where like LL Cool J's focus is more on pushing a positive message, which is always a good thing. Is always, always a good thing. You're changing the world for the better. It just makes some of the songs like on the edge of getting boring. It gets pretty close to boring, but like not really. Right when the song ends, it goes into the next song, you're like, oh, okay, yo, this doesn't sound boring. So it's like, I think it's just how LL Cool J approaches every song. Because LL Cool J is an old school rapper, he's gonna stick to what he's good at, and that's basically killing off hard beats. He gets a hard beat and he goes ballistic. He just destroys that. He uses that same formula for almost every song on the album. Not every single song. There's like maybe 4 songs out of the 14 where he tries like a little bit of a different style. But for most of the album, he uses that same formula where Q-Tip throws him like a hot beat, and he just tries to kill it as hard as he can with his lyrical ability. And I mean, that's basically hip hop when you think about it. Like, that's how the genre works. Like, you know what I mean? You go your absolute hardest on cool sounding sampled beats for the most part, you know what I mean? That's like the definition of what rap music is. But focusing on LL Cool J's raps, he uses like that same kill off the beat formula on every single song. It's not that much of a problem, because LL Cool J, he does a crazy job at it. He does his thing. And because of how strong the production is from Q-Tip, it doesn't really make too much of a difference at the end of the day. That's the only bad thing I can think of, right? In terms of a rating for this album, I'm giving this one a 9.5 out of 10. There is nothing bad I can say about the album, man. Like, LL Cool J's verses on here are almost untouchable. I don't think there's a lot of rappers that that can keep up with LL Cool J on a lyrical standpoint, I had to give this one a 9.5, man. The features did an excellent job for them to come up with an album like this in 2024. Pretty crazy, man. Pretty crazy. One of the best albums I've heard so far this year. 9.5 out of 10. LL Cool J, The Force. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this one. Plenty more content and music to come afterwards. I'll keep you guys posted about that. I really appreciate you guys watching today's episode. Yeah, man. Thanks for watching. I'm out.